will talk about not only the ask, but it'll include an infographic of words and pictures and pictures and words. Of best practices, what works, what really makes success, what are the stories that go into making that success for that student, and finally, what is the localized vision that you have to get that B word. And finally,
as we're shattering those library walls and expanding to the community, that we need to make sure that there are equitable resources for all kids. And sometimes even when we have programs that target students of low socioeconomic status, there are kids that get lost in the middle. I know I...
demonstrating leadership, because administrators need to see school library media specialists as leaders. So demonstrating leadership by holding a mini summit at your school that involves all stakeholders, students, teachers, parents, administrators, and by asking them the question, what about our school keeps you up at night?
Did with me last year and go, yeah, you know, we're talking about Europe before Schengen, and can you maybe talk about the number of people from the Czech Republic that immigrated into Germany in the 1970s? Can you help with that? And I'm like,
librarians can go and be part of a special interest group of school librarians from across the nation, connect with resources that support any level of entry where you are with STEAM.
How do we include ourselves into the solution? And at the last 5 minutes, we realized, oh, we really need to look at how do we embed ourselves into these broader systems. So one of the first things that we discovered was...
we decided, you know, our problems are access. How are we going to get these resources out? And so we decided to do exactly what they said by smashing the silos. So we're going to get access to everybody and all over. Being at home, being at school. We're gonna make our virtual visible. So all those ebooks, all of our online resources, we're gonna give a visual appeal to them.
So when thinking about curating for personalized learning in an age of one-to-one and making the library accessible beyond the walls 24/7, the problem was time. And the problem was that personalized learning is just that, personalized, just one of us. We need to empower students and teachers to become the curators for their own interests and learning needs. Instead of holding the keys, we need to open the door. And
drop-down menus to determine what type of information you want and who you want to give this information to.